This is fish number four, the staghorn sculpin. This is the side view of the fish, and this is the angle I want you to draw it at. When you're looking at it, you can see one eye on this side, and you would see the other eye on the other side. When you look at them from above, it can be tempting to think they have both eyes on the same side, but you can draw the midline between them. Right here's the dorsal fin sitting on the midline, and if you extend that forward, you have one eye on the left and one eye on the right. So this fish doesn't have its eyes on the same side, they are just towards the top, right? And its head looks a little flattened, like someone stepped on it. This is the pectoral fin. The pelvic fin is underneath. You can't see it from this view, so don't worry about labeling it. You have the anal fin at the back, on the belly, the caudal fin, and then the dorsal fin is here. You can see the lateral line down the side as well. This is the operculum. It's got these little extensions on it. This is why we call it a staghorn, because it has horns like an antler, like a deer, right? The stags. And those are part of the operculum. They're attached to it. They're not something separate. For this one, you are going to need to have the hints in order to get to the correct family name. So the pelvic fins, which are underneath here, are thoracic with one spine and five soft rays, and they're not modified into a cup or a disc form. You can see the two separate fins quite clearly. It does not have any finlets. The anal fin does not have any spines, but the dorsal fin does. So use that. Good luck finding the family name, and if you run into trouble, let me know.